Hey, folks, it's the coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team.
It's always like the ultimate dick kick every
Here's
time.
Here's the Australian-born punter, Mitch Wishnowsky, to get things going. And we are underway from Kansas City. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. Here's the Chiefs offense for their first possession, and it's Patrick Mahomes at quarterback.
And when you think of Patrick Mahomes, you start to think about all of his attributes, and you realize very quickly, you can't just put him into one box. No matter how the game proceeds, no matter what is needed, he tends to have an answer for it and plays accordingly.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at about the 32. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, complete. That's Gonzalez. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
So, yep, we're just doing that again real quick. Fuck it. Just nope. Nope. Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a to you. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers in the killer town. Kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chilling. Click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real. About to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Welcome, everybody. I'm the coach. Up next, another ultimate challenge on EA Sports.
Here's the Australian-born punter, Mitch Wishnowsky, to get things going.
And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team.
A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
And simply put, for many, he's the gold standard for quarterbacks in today's NFL because of his ability to create, find the open man, use all the different arm angles that he has. He's a complete package, and boy, his team loves to play around him.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. A first carry now for Reggie Bush. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. The second play from scrimmage, the same as the first, a 3-yard run. Now here's Mahomes. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gonzalez. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll run on first down. Alexander, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down. That was a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Here's Mahomes to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Clock running, under a minute to go in a scoreless first quarter. On first down, it's Alexander. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here, 3rd and 1 yard. No score after 1 on EA Sports. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's 3rd and 1 yard. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line.
I like his focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up 2.
Mahomes going to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So they need 2 yards here on 3rd down. Remember, they're already 2 of 2 on 3rd down conversions on this drive. Throwing now is Mahomes. And in for the Chiefs touchdown.
Woo!
Patrick Mahomes with a touchdown pass to
James
Watkins.
Get away.
As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Justin Tucker for the extra point. His kick is good to make it 7-0 KC. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. San Francisco gets set to go here. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here 1st and 10 at their own 22. He'll look to Mostert to start things out. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now Garoppolo. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he will get enough for a 1st down, and that will lead us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. You in just a couple of minutes. We'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
Oh, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for 4th down. Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. Kansas City taking the field for their 2nd drive. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They run the counter. Alexander. Now another timeout called for by the offense. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be third and 10 now. Back to throw. There, third and long on your own side of the field, just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for third and short. Because when
it... And look at this, it's a fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. They'll find Ayuk open right side. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on first. To throw again on second down. Garoppolo getting this out to the flat. Mostert. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
Looking to throw again on second down. Garoppolo will get this into the hands of Ayuk. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw is Garoppolo. He's got Ayuk once again. And the 49ers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Kyle Juszczyk, excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Niners are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Gold with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken in at the 3. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Chiefs going to go back on offense one final time in this first half. And they really won't have much time to work with, just 19 seconds showing on the clock. Airing this one out for Fitzgerald. And that is incomplete.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Now, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Let's take it.
So a costly penalty yardage-wise, as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football,
are you fucking kidding me?
And intercepted. Picked off by the former first rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half.
An abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, well, get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little, kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Now Mahomes. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. He's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. It's a big play there for the Chiefs. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. On the run, it's Bush. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
On second down now. It's Alexander, and he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Third and 1, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
They'll run on first down. Alexander. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9. On the delay, it's Bush. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's 3rd and 2 now. They'll try and run for the first with Bush. And he has the first down as he's able to reach the ball forward and get past the line to gain. It'll be first and goal when we come back. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. He'll try again. And he will take for a Chiefs touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. There's Garoppolo on 1st and 10. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. Touchdown, 49ers! George Kittle. 73 yards. And the Niners are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
That's not an excuse. That was bullshit.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded right around the 8. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. And now here comes Kansas City. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. The drive starts with Reggie Bush. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 55 rushing yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
You gotta burn that clock, baby. That's where you play that shitty game.
On first down, they stick with Bush. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Now it's 2nd and 9. They'll hand it off to Bush. And he'll take this forward for about 5 as we have come upon the 2-minute warning. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And they're facing a big 3rd down now in this tie ball game. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. 3 yards on the keeper, and it's 4th down.
So oh, fuck, the field
Justin
goal.
Justin Tucker in a big spot. This for the lead in the final stages.
That's good.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there.
I didn't want that to be the case, but
so he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
true.
Time.
That's
I mean,
true.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Back to throw, Garoppolo. Able to haul it in is Kittle. And they worked this well upfield across the 45. Garoppolo to throw. Got a man. That's Ayuk. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. To throw is Garoppolo. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
That's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle. So
and Troy Hill gets to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Troy Hill picks it. And the Chiefs have just about sewn up this football game. When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on 1st down. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down. Now the Niners going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout. As they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. On 2nd down, It's Alexander, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Now another timeout called for by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Where's it at?
Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more, little insult to injury here late in the game. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And they stretch the lead to 6. It's 20-14 now. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense and make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short of the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can come. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted.
Woo! Yeah!
31.
And
the Chiefs are going to hang on. On the final play, they get the turnover to seal this football game.
Fuck, I'll take it.
Nicely done. Another one up, another one down. Keep grinding and keep racking up those wins.
Man,